Here's a line in C7th that I like to play. It skips some strings, and just getting your hands, getting your right hand to skip strings is really important, because I think what happens is that you don't play scales. You don't play up and down a scale and the scale tones you're used to practicing. Instead, you break up those scales into much more melodic ideas. So this is what the line is. I'll play at normal speed first. Lots of different ways you can do it tempo-wise. One time in triplets, one time I played it straight. And what I'm doing is I'm starting on a C, but I'm in the 12th position, so that would be my fourth finger on the C, way up here on the fifth string. Then I go to a G, so I've skipped the fourth string, and then a B flat, also on that third string, and then up to a high E and G. Okay, now I do that line. I do that line all the time in the key of C. You know, it's real useful dominant seventh type stuff. But in this case, I'm going to go up there to the high G, and then this first finger is going to play an E, slide down to a D. And then I'm going to play B flat, A, G, F. And instead of scalarly going down to an E, I'm going to jump an octave here and go to this octave. So and so this is my part of my revival downs lick that is shown extensively in another lesson. But in the key of C, it's going to be E, C, G, B flat. So the third, the root, the fifth, the seventh. Then I switch to eighth position, play the root C, and then just down a dominant. You know, you could even go to a minor third. So wherever you want to take it at the end. I usually end it probably taking a little farther than E. All those ideas are cool, you know, they all work depending on the context, the tempo, everything else, but they'll all work for the key of C. So once again, you're in the 12th position, starting on a C, right? And instead of coming back down like that, I'm staying up there, switching down to the 10th position, and then B flat, A, G, F, and then so. Anyway, nice little line to have. All right, so that's C7th. Let's try it in A7. Just get your hands used to skipping strings like that with your right hand, and any lines you can come up with that are musical. You know, you don't want to just be skipping strings to skip strings. You want to skip them because that next interval is the right one to play. So it's not about technique, it's about music all the time.